Sean, that's right. Asking around town this morning, nobody seems to know the accused, who, according to the complaint charging him with first-degree murder, lived just up the street from his victim. But there is very much a sense of relief here in town now that word is beginning to filter out that an arrest has been made.
It was a shock, to be sure.
Henniker was rocked last week with the murder of one of its citizens. Molly Hawthorn-MacDougall, seen here in a photograph with her husband Daniel Paul, was found shot to death Thursday morning inside her home at 18 Rand Road. The Attorney General's office says the man who pulled the trigger was 22-year-old Rudy Fleur-Goost. This morning at the local coffee shop, news of the arrest was welcome. The owner saying the past few days have been nerve-wracking.
Everybody's a little nervous. No, you know, hoping that they would wrap it up, figure it out, because it is a small town. We don't see hardly any crime here.
The police chief says things have been different since the murder.
I feel the community was on edge, concerned about their safety. There was a lot of questions that were unanswered. For investigative reasons, we could not answer these questions.
And the lack of information, says St. George, was one of the most frustrating things people were dealing with.
They had told us we had nothing to worry about. That's what I heard, so I wasn't extremely worried, but, you know, you always have that little fear.
Now, with someone charged, the chief hopes that some of those fears have been put to bed, but he thinks it'll still take some time before Henniker is back to normal.
But I think this community is going to take a while for the community to heal from something so tragic like this.
As possible, we could learn more information about an hour from now when the arraignment of the 22-year-old is scheduled to take place. Reporting live in Henniker, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.